morning Pacific Standard Time. And these are, you know. This is G sharp 2. This is the key of F sharp. G sharp is the second note in the key of F. This is F1, or F sharp 1, F sharp. It's the second note in the key. G sharp, F sharp is the first note. Okay, a little reminder, this is how we know we're in the right spot. Okay, we're all familiar with that song, right? Hopefully. It's an Illuminati song, but it's the only thing we have really that's widely known that people can relate to, so we can teach music at least. Okay, G sharp 2, right? Sharp 2 arpeggio, and I threw in a little target note practice in there for a little change up, a little F1, a little F sharp 2 for a change up, just to give it a little flavor. This is our emotion right here. This is the feeling that's going through our bodies right now. It's vibrating. It vibrates at so many times a minute. Since it's probably about 400, around there, around 400 times a minute, it's making the body vibrate. So it makes the body feel a certain way. I just landed on the F sharps, or the F7, and I just held it. So once we start holding it, then a new feeling starts coming. We hold it. When we hold it, we get a new feeling, right? Y'all know about holding things, right? A whole new feeling comes on, right? Yeah. That's what you call some aggressive digging, man. Passionate, aggressive digging. I was digging so hard, my pick flicked right out of my hands. But anyway, that's a whole new feeling. It's a whole new emotion. It's different from that number two emotion. This F right here that I was playing, instead of around 400, it's probably around 375 vibrations a minute, because it's a lower note. It has more slack in it. It's looser. It's not as tight. If I bring it up, it's tighter. Take it down, it's looser. More slack. More play in it. More slop. Right. Now what's this? That's intergalactic ascension. That's just a fancy way for saying it's the next octave. It's the same note. Okay, whenever we play two notes in a row, right? Two different notes, the relationship between those two notes is known as an interval. It's an interval. That's why I called it intervalactic. And I went from a low note to the high octave. So that's going low to high is ascending. So I called it intervalactic ascension. It's the same note, it's the same feeling, but the feeling's a little different now. Because it's really tighter now. It's way tight. It's a way higher note. But it's based around the same feeling. There because our creator sends them when we start looking for them. The creator has already sent the melody. We just grab onto it. It just drops right into our mind. Time to spend on it, and you know. What note is that? Well, let's see if we can find it. There's its octave right there. One of its octaves. I know how to find octaves. My ear is trained at it. An octave is the easiest interval of all the intervals to find. It's the easiest of all ones to recall in our minds. As a side note. I was to try to do like an octave, like an intervalactic relationship between a note and a different note. All right, I need lots of practice on that one. I'm still figuring that out, man. But the octave to find the same note, the octave is the exact same note. At a higher or lower pitch, and that's the easiest one to find. It's easiest to find the exact same note in our minds, to recall it in our minds and to sing it. I can do it just like that. It's like clockwork every time. But to find another one, if someone was to ask me, hey man, can you do a fifth? Can you do a third? Can you do a major second? I'd be like, I'd have to play it first. Dun dun, there's a major fifth. That's a power chord, by the way. All heavy metal power chords are made up of a perfect fifth. Or it's a fifth. It's called a fifth. Perfect fifth. Can you sing me a perfect fifth? I'd have to play it on my guitar first. Dun 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 dun. There it is. Dun 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 dun. Can you play me an octave? No problem. Can you sing me an octave right out of your mind? No problem. I can do it every time, just like clockwork. So what was this note? There it was. Well, let's see. Let's number them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That was a 5 note. Do, dear, female, dear. Okay. So I know my finger patterns. Okay. If we don't know them, then we'd have to learn them. But since how I know them, I just made quick reference. 1, 2, 3. 3 notes per string. 4, 5, 6. 3 notes per string. 7, 1, 2. 3 notes per string. 3, 4, 5. There it is. It's a 5 note. This is the octave. That's the number 5 emotion, by the way. There it is. It has its own feeling as we sit there and hold it. Okay, but what gives it its real feeling? It's the fact that we play all the other notes in the key with it, right? Or against it. 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5. Now that I've done that, right? I've played the note and I've played the scale. Okay, this is a bit of a prerequisite for beginning to have melodies just drop into the mind. Now my mind is automatically zeroed in on the sound of the notes. Play that one note and hold it, a 5. Now my mind's gonna go on automatic pilot and it'll start dropping melodies in from the Creator. From the Most High. Just drops melodies right in there. Let yourself feel. was all just right out of spontaneous, right out of thin air. Boom, right on the spot. Bam. Didn't even have to think about it. Well, you know, I thought about where I was going with my notes a little bit. I didn't even think about that. I just grabbed different notes. I didn't even think about what note I was going to. So, like, you know, music is like automatic pilot. Or it's automatic. I don't want to use the word pilot because I'm not into flying. I think it's dangerous. Very, very dangerous. I don't fly. I don't get on planes. Nothing. Heck no. Not only that, it encourages all the chemtrail spraying pilots. They're like, oh, he's talking about automatic pilot. Cool. I'm up here spraying chemtrails. He supports me. I don't support him at all.
Two, three, four.
notes, right? How long do we want to hold something, right? Some of us only like to hold for a second. Some of us like to hold for a long time. Sometimes it depends on our mood. We only want to hold something for 1 second. Sometimes we want to hold it for a little longer. Depends on how we feel, right? Or if we detect that something needs to be held, how about that? Right here. They feel like they want to all be held at the same time. Each individually, though. Say, my turn, 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 my turn. Seconds. Always coming back to that three. Okay, there's the three note again, except it's decorated with two other notes. But we have that three emotion in our minds right now. So our mind is on automatic, zeroing in on that three emotion, that feeling. Although I'm playing two other notes with it, it's still still on automatic. It's listening to that three. It's enjoying that feeling. Any note in the key, right? Or I can just grab any note and turn it into any key I want. I just pick up the guitar and say, oh. And then just start playing scales. I have them memorized, so I'll just play any scale. Not even the note in that scale. So what have we just done? We created an emotion, right, that most of the world isn't used to feeling, because it's not in the key. In a way, this particular one, yeah, it, most of the world feels this way. That's known as a harmonic minor emotion. But I had no idea what I was doing. I had to figure it out. But I have some theory in my head, so I was able to figure it out. Okay. This note's not in the key. This is the key of G sharp. And then when I do this, it just turned it into the key of D. D harmonic minor. Anyway, that's advanced stuff. So just pick a note. Most of us are used to just, you know, on guitar, just used to playing open notes, an open A string, an open A power chord. Yeah. We're like, yeah. Okay, so... we could consciously, we could on purpose make a decision. On purpose we could make a decision here. We have seven notes to choose from, right? And we have A. So this could be A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, A6, or A7. And each one of those numbers is a different emotion, a different feeling. So I can either just start playing my key scales that I have memorized. If we don't have any key scales memorized, all we have to do is just take little pieces of tape and make little dots where each note's supposed to be. Right? Just go on YouTube and type in the YouTube search, 3 notes per string. And there's plenty of videos. Everybody's made videos on 3 notes per string. 3 notes per string scale. And I'll show you where all the notes are at. And you just look at the patterns and you just put little pieces of tape on your guitar. then you'll be proficient in one key. That's all we need to start out, is just one key. I remember when I started out with one key. I just picked a spot on the neck and just started practicing. I didn't put any pieces of tape down. I wasn't that smart back then. I didn't think of that back then. But I've thought of it now today. I've done it. I've done it like 10 years ago on this one bass. I used to have a bass. I put the things on the bass. But you know, now that I think about it, I said, man, if I would have just thought about putting little pieces of tape where each note is, that would have made it a lot easier for me. Instead, I was just memorizing them, playing them, memorizing them. So that's all we need, you know? We have our guitar all keyed up, right? Just put little pieces of tape. Then we'd know where all the notes are. So all we'd have to do is, if we had a little help, we could purposely make it so the A note is one of those notes. Just put little pieces of tape. And then what we can do too is put the numbers on them. Put a little piece of tape. Something that we can write on, or a sticker, something that takes a pen, you know, and just mark it. That's the number one note, that's number two, number three, number four, number five, number six, number seven. And then it repeats itself. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. All the way up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. On every string. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then we can look at it, we can say, oh, okay, let me play a one note today. I feel like playing the one feeling. I feel like a number one today. So I'm going to play that, and I'm going to play the number one. Or we could say, well, I'm going to tape my guitar up. I'm going to put the notes on here. I'm going to choose the key that's A1, the A, the key of A. The number one note is always the number of the key. It's always the key. Number one is always the key. So if it's the A note, A1 is the key of A. Yeah, I feel like A1 on. I think I'm going to tape my guitar up for A1. Some of us would be like, man, I think I'm going to tape my guitar up for C-sharp 4, man. C-sharp 4. So then we'd have to ask ourselves, well, C sharp is the fourth note of what key? So that would be the key of G sharp. So we tape our guitar up for the key of G sharp. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. Do, You know, or if we need, we just do a YouTube search, you know, or a Google search, you know, we can type in there, you know, what are all the notes in the key G sharp? You know, just keep looking, keep searching. What are all the notes? Where are all the notes for C sharp 4? What key is that? Someone will be able to tell us. There'll be something on the internet about it. These are the notes for guitar right here. Dun, 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 dun. So then we look at it, we take our pieces of tape, put little pieces of tape, and now we have all the notes right there, and now we can just do 3 notes per string. No, at first we might be like this. Right. But we can pick one of those notes and feel it, and we'd be like, we don't have to do a power chord, we can just do one note. And then just put our fingers on some of the pieces of tape and just have keep our fingers right there, right? And just play those notes. It accomplishes the same thing. So we have that feeling. This is the G sharp 1 feeling. How do we know it's, what gives it its feeling? Because we played some notes in the key. That's what gives it its feeling. You know, or if we have a little more skill. Some of the notes in the scale and always coming back to that G sharp 1. Just play each note in the scale one at a time. Play notes in the scale. Now I have a song, and my mind will make a melody automatically. Now I have a song. How we'll have our notes all over the neck, we can quickly go to where all the notes are and always come back to that G sharp and always make sure we land on the number 1 note. And since we'll have them numbered, you know, we can do a slower song. Da-da-da. 1, 1, 1. So we just always remember to look for the number 1. Just land on the number 1. It's our target. All the other numbers, we don't have to pay attention to them. We're just looking for the pieces of tape. And we're always keeping our mind on the number 1. Number 1. because we're attracted to doing it, right? We're motivated to do it. We're attracted to doing it. Not everybody's attracted to doing guitar. Not everybody's attracted to it. As time progresses, we start learning to be more selective with our notes. We start making patterns out of them and playing the same notes all the time. And our fingers get used to playing the same old patterns all the time. Sure, our finger goes on the tape while we're holding the other notes. You know, it all depends on us. Now we can get creative, right? We can choose our notes, be selective how we want to choose our notes. And at first, we're going to be like, we're going to try to sound like what we hear all the time. We're like, I want to sound like that. That sounds cool. So we try to sound like that. And then we might ask someone, hey man, how do we get that sound? How do we do that one? And they'll show us. Do it like this. Put your finger here, finger there. Do it just like that. There's YouTube videos. There's thousands of people out there on guitar showing everybody all the things they like to do. This is the way I like to do it, man. Some people are hard to follow, others are easier, so, you know, some people were made to follow hard people. Some people like it hard, man. Some people like it easy. All kinds of different people in the world, man. See, I like it hard, man. I want it hard. I want it difficult to learn, man. That's the way I learn. I like it when it's difficult. That's what motivates me. Other people are like, man, I like it when it's easy, man. Other man's like, I like it in between, man. Not too hard, not too easy. Man, a little bit of friction, just a little bit. Everybody has their own learning curve, right? G sharp 1. Now I could tell myself, I'd rather have this be G sharp 5. Okay, now I have to go to my toolbox and grab a tool. What's my tool? I'm going to grab my key question tool. It's called the key question tool. If I grab my tool, if I have to, I'll make my own tool. So I'll write it down, put it in my toolbox. Right. Here's one of my key question tools, my little tool. I have it written down right here. I posted it right there. Key question tools. G sharp 5. G sharp is the fifth note of what key? There's my tool. That's my question tool. Right? Then I have to figure it out. Go on the internet, YouTube search it. G sharp is the fifth note of what key? Da, 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 da. Google search it. Or, right? We can learn how to figure it out ourselves. That comes with time. There's a formula to figure it out. Do a deer, female deer, a tropical sun, me a name, call my own. That's just a memory song to help us remember the interval of the notes, kind of. there's a formula to figuring out what notes go where. What's the space? How many frets between each finger? Do we skip a fret? Or do we not skip a fret? Do we skip a fret? Or do we skip two frets? Is it just one fret or two frets? Just one note, one right after the other. Skip a fret. A fret right here, this is the space. These little bars, these are little metal bars on the neck called frets. Right? So a metal bar there, a metal bar there, in between the metal bars is a piece of wood. That's a fret. Or a space. And there's a formula to figure it out. It goes like this. If there's a space, right, we can call it a space. If there's not a space, we'll call it a no space. So it goes like this. We pick our note. Here's the formula. Space, space, no space. Space, space, no space. Space, space, pick our note. Space, space, no space. Space, 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 no space. So two spaces in a row and a no space. And three spaces in a roll and a no space. Or what I like to call, how I learned it, is if there's a space, it's called a hole. If there's a no space, it's called a half. So, hole, hole, take a half hour break. That's the way I see it. Hole, hole, take a half hour break. Three more holes, take another half hour break. Two holes, right? Here's the note. Hole, hole, take a half hour break. Hole, 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 take a half hour break. Two holes, take a half hour break. Three holes, take a half hour break. So the first note is one. Hole is two. Second hole is third note. Half is the fourth note. Hole, hole, half. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. So I'm on the fourth note. The second part of it is whole, 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 half. Three holes and a half. Four, five, six, seven, one. Five, six, seven, one. So it brings us back to one. Okay. Two holes, take a half. Three more holes, take another half hour break. So you could relate it to like being on the job site. Okay. I have to work two whole hours. Take a half hour break. Now I have to work three more whole hours. Now I'm gonna take another half hour break. If they give you that half hour break, second half hour break. Well, you usually get 2:15s, right? Or 2:10s, so. Two half hour breaks, basically, throughout the day. So that's how we can figure out where the note is, what the key is. So if we're sitting here and we're on the number four note, if we want to make this G sharp four or G sharp five, but easier than all that, right? Easier than all that, it's already going to be taped on here. It's already going to be taped on here. You're going to have the key things already taped on there, right? But we're only going to be in one key, right? Right, one key. We're only going to have one key taped on here. Right? But I'm just saying, if we want to tape up our guitar to G sharp 5, if we want to tape it up for a key, right? We're going to have to Google search it for all the notes, or we can figure it out ourselves, you know? Some of us like to do that. So I'm just giving giving this other tidbit of information for those of us that like to figure things out ourselves. You know, some of us need to be told. We want, like to ask, hey, what is it? What is it? Man, give me the answer. What is it? Okay. Some of us are like, ah, don't tell me, don't tell me. Just give me a couple clues. I'll figure it out. Right? Some people like to hear the whole story. Tell me the whole story, man. There are people like, nah, 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 don't tell me anything. I'm going to figure it out. So, you know, if we want to learn what the formula is, we can just type it on YouTube. Put in their major scale formula. Music scale formula. And it'll say whole, whole, half, whole, 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 half. All the time. Whole, whole, half for the major scale. The famous music scale. So if we have our little formula, then all we have to do is align up our little musical formula scale so that the G sharp is the number 5 note of that scale. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Well, now I have to figure out where's the G sharp to make it easy. There's a G sharp right there. I already know where it's at. Now we have to figure out where all the G sharps are on the neck to make it easy. So we just transfer the pattern. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Well, this is the pattern. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this is the G sharp down here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I'll take it up here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There it is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Oh, there's the number 1 note. What's the name of that note? E, F, F sharp, G, G sharp, A, A sharp, B, C, D, D sharp. So it's the key D sharp. No, wait. Key of D. Key of C sharp. Okay, that's C sharp. G sharp 5. G sharp. We'll grab our tool. G sharp is the 5th note of what key? Oh. 3, 2, 1, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. What is this note? C sharp. G sharp 5 is the key of C sharp. Ah, okay. So I'll tape my guitar up. I'll remember where it's at, and then I'll tape my little piece of the tape, and I'll tape it up for the key of G sharp, or the key of C sharp. So then I can enjoy that number. I can enjoy that G sharp 5 emotion. I like that G sharp 5 emotion. Or I just want to pick it. Like, I feel like taping my guitar up for the G sharp 5 emotion. Those notes and the key from the C sharp scale. Now the emotion came. Did you feel it? Now we have a feeling. G sharp 5. G sharp 5. Thank you. Always coming back to that one note, that G sharp 5. I have a song. Right? But that takes skill. Right? and a want and a need. You know, it all depends on us. What's our level of need? What's our level of want? How much motivation we got? Right? Is it really that important to us? You know? You know, it might be really important to him, but it's not that important to me. Right? F#4, always coming back to that F#4. Playing my little pieces of tape where I got my key all taped up. Searching for that number four note, right? What if we have our guitar all taped up for the key and each note numbered, one through seven, all over? We just look at it and always go to that number four if we feel like that number four emotion. Right? Now, if I wanted to, I could say to myself, let's make this F#3. I don't want to do F#4 anymore. I don't want to make it F#3. Now we just change keys. Whenever we change the number, we change the keys. So F#3 is the third note of what key? Well, I'm just gonna find it real quick. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, key of D. There it is, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1. I know what my three notes per string patterns are. If this is a